This Sunday marks the 50-year anniversary of the network news in New Zealand.
To honour this monumental occasion, we now present a specially adapted Friday Countdown.
It's the Friday Countdown!
Tragedy today in Wellington Harbour.
It was the sinking of the Wahine in 1968 which got the network ball rolling. Footage from the wreck could only be seen in Wellington on that fateful day. The rest of the country had to wait. And so it was that a national network was fast-tracked to connect us all.
The main artery of this system is a chain of microwave stations from Auckland to Dunedin.
In Wellington today,
the first and best of all the presenters was, like Prince, known only by one name, and that name was Dougal.
Japanese fishing boats have again been poaching in New Zealand waters.
Fellow serious white men hogged the limelight after him. But in 1975, Jenny Goodwin was allowed into the sausage sizzle and became the first woman in the Commonwealth to read the network news.
Hello and greetings from Auckland, New Zealand.
The ladies never left, and to this day, men like myself are forced to play second fiddle. In the glory days, it seemed the whole country was glued to the news, and we shared some remarkable moments. Older viewers will remember the amazing UFO sighting of Kaikoura in 1978, or our own Miss Universe in 1983, Humphrey the Sea Elephant in 88, or the fall of the Berlin Wall in 89, and the fall of Georgie Pie in 1996.
Sleep deprived, but super well.
Whether completely sober or incredibly pissed. Prime ministers have always made for great telly.
Smart Alec interviewer.
But the angry ball of power that lived within Muldoon was always the most compelling.
Do you consider bringing two television cameras out here as warranted?
Two! 7 Sharp is but the latest in a long line of 7pm shows.
Kia ora and welcome to 7 Sharp. Here's what caught our eye.
Her cleavage. Originally, the regions had their own programs, many of which had soft porn names, like Top Half and The Mainland Touch. But the regions succumbed to the network when Paul Holmes emerged in 1989 with a blood sacrifice called Dennis Connor.
And thank you very much for having me.
But would you be interested in apologising to Mr. Farr in public, Mr. Connor, for that incident that happened last year?
But at number one, we would be nothing without our brave reporters and camera people, many of whom have made fools of themselves for our viewing pleasure. Some have been victims of angry outbursts from feisty foes. Like Sir Bob Jones, who emerged Yeti-like to paint reporter Rod Vaughan's face in his own claret.
Can I ask you,
before I start walloping you now, piss off!
Strangest of all was serial fraudster Giovanni Di Stefano, who took on not one, but two of TVNZ's finest.
Why, you think I'm scared of you?
Others have taken it on the chin and even faced death by giant horse. So here's to the camera folk, to the backroom toilers, the face painters, the makers of the cool graphics. And here's to this guy. And, as Jenny Goodwin said half a century ago,
well, for New Zealand, it's certainly been an honour to have taken part in this programme.
And that's...
It's the Friday!
Yeah, and that person that was run over by the Clydesdale is Melissa's partner, actually.
I know, Jerry only just told me he's never mentioned it at home.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I thought that he probably would have said something. Favourite news moment?
Not a favourite I can think of at the moment, but an add-on to the Rod Vaughan. But apparently when the judge said to Bob Jones, you have to pay $1,000, he said, why don't I pay two and I can do it again?
That's pretty good, isn't it?
Yours?
Mine is probably actually a personal moment with Angela Dorday, when she sat on my desk as a 20-year-old in a leopard print miniskirt. So it's got me excited even thinking about it.
Goodness.
I'll leave you with that thought. Those are